Hello, hello, everybody. It's 5:20 p.m. Central Time on the 28th of November, 2022. It's Monday here in the United States. I've got something I want to show you really quick. This is going to be a very quick video just to show you a heat signature that showed up out in the ocean first before the Hawaii eruption. Now, to see it, I'm going to put a link down below for everybody to go look themselves. Depending on what kind of screen you're looking on or what kind of resolution you're on, you might not be able to see it. I'm going to put my mouse around it here, and then I'm going to move it back and forth, and it's just a little red splotch. This is out in the ocean, a few thousand feet down at a place called Loihi, an undersea mount that's out there in the ocean just south of Pahala. Now, I can do a few things to maybe adjust how we view this. So I can turn, for instance, our saturation up, and I can, you know, make it more, you know, there's a lot more color in there. Okay, we can do that. We can also adjust the brightness if we need to maybe help you see it. I don't know if this will help you see it or not, but it is blinking off and on there. And then we just come forward about an hour and a half later, then we have our big eruption. Now, right around the same time on land, you can see something happen at Kilauea. It's ever so light. You can't really see it on this feed, actually, quite frankly. Now, if we go over to shortwave infrared, it shows us black splotches where the heat signatures are. And I'll take you back to the time in question, and you might, I don't know if we'll see it. Let's see if we'll see it through the cloud cover. It might be hard to see through the cloud cover. It's ever so faint. Let's go back a little bit. It is showing right here as a little black gray square. I mean, it's barely showing up, but again, it's down in the ocean. So I'll go back to the natural color fire view. This is our most current view, but what I'm interested in is what happened right before. So definitely something blinking right out there. The time stamp on this, if you're looking at GOES West satellite, GOES 17 RGB natural color fire view, and the timestamp is 6:20 and 28 seconds UTC time. So November 22nd at 6:20, 28 UTC. And if you look close on your own computer, if you can't see it here on this, let me take the saturation down and adjust the gamma. Maybe turn the gamma up a little bit. Maybe that'll help. And again, we're looking right down here, just directly above the NOV on the timestamp. Okay, so there's definitely something showing up out there really quick. And then we get our big eruption. And it's pretty rare to get eruptive activity out at Loihi. It doesn't happen all the time. That's why I wanted to show it to you. Again, I don't know if this is going to really help us. If you're going to see this, maybe contrast up or down might help us too. Contrast up or down. Let me get it back on the screen here. Right here. Put my mouse tip right in the middle of it. So it's important to document these things. Again, I don't know if USGS or anybody would be, you know, actually catching this. They're looking even at these sort of things out in the ocean on GOES satellite. They wouldn't think to check the fire view for out in the ocean a couple hours beforehand. I mean, who would think to check, right? So there it is. It's flickering on and off out in the ocean about 5,000 feet deep, which shows something significant happened out there first. And this happened at 6:20 UTC time. And then by 9:20, 3 hours later, boom. So first this out in the ocean, then 3 hours later, this on land. Pretty interesting, right? And that's why I'm documenting it. So I at least hope maybe people can at least see it. If you can't, I'll put a link down below so you can see it. You might even need to watch on like a big screen TV and adjust the brightness on your screen itself to look at it on the link. It's that pale. Again, it's 5,000 feet down in the ocean. It's not supposed to pick up fire signatures in the ocean. All right, guys. Much love. I will save this and get this out over on YouTube so everybody can see it. But in the meantime, we do have links that I can provide to different channels who are covering live coverage in Hawaii. That's doing Hawaii. We also have two pineapples who's also covering that. Really good stuff. So Two Pineapples and Doing Hawaii, two different channels in Hawaii who I would recommend to watch for updates on this, to get live views on the volcano and the lava flow as it's taking place. Okay, much love, guys. Peace out. And I will be back if anything else goes down. We'll get some seismic updates out later on tonight going into tomorrow.